Hey guys, how are you all? I hope you all are well. I am Sunita and I welcome you on my channel Lovable Plants. In today's video, I want to show you this beautiful healthy plant known as spider plant. The spider plant is among the most adaptable house plant and very easy to grow. As you can see, I have planted it in many pots. The spider plant is also known for its tremendous air purifying quality, which makes it a healthy addition to your home as well. Native to tropical and southern Africa, spider plant have a reputation for being nearly impossible to kill. These fast growing fun plants are a great option for the first time plant owner. Now let's know how to take care of this plant. Spider plant can tolerate lower light conditions. However, they prefer bright indirect light where they will flourish. The striping on the leaves will be more prominent with indirect light. Avoid direct sunlight as it may burn its leaves. You can also use grow light if you don't have any suitable place for this plant. Water your spider plant when the top 50% of the soil is dry. Water until liquid flows through the drainage hole at the bottom of the pot and discard any water that has accumulated in the saucer. If you notice browning leaf tips, it can be from chemicals found in water which cause buildup. If this is the case, allow the water to sit out overnight before watering, or you can use filtered water for this plant. Your spider plant will do well in low humidity environments but will thrive with a bit more humidity. Brown leaf tips may indicate the air is too dry, so mist your spider plant regularly using a mister. Your plant prefers temperatures between 15 to 26 degrees Celsius during the daytime and above 12 degrees Celsius at night. You can feed your plant once every month during the spring and summer with a liquid fertilizer for indoor plants. Mature spider plant will produce spiderets or pups. These are new plant offshoots from the mother plant that you can trim off and nurture to produce an entirely new plant. To propagate, cut out the small plant from the mother and place the bottom end in a glass of water. You should see roots developing in 2 to 4 weeks time. After roots develop, plant the pup in soil and water regularly. If your spider plant is in need of a trim, clean up your plant using clean, sharp plant snips. Spider plants are tough when it comes to pests, but they are susceptible to some pest infestations. Aphids, mealybugs, and spider mites can eat your spider plant. But this can be avoided by misting your plant every once in a while. You can wash your plant with pressured water. It will drown these pests. In case attack is severe, then you can use organic neem oil spray by adding 1 to 2 ml neem oil in 1 liter water. Spider plants do occasionally develop small white flowers at the end of their long arching stems. Flowers on spider plants can grow in a cluster or can be single, depending on the variety of the spider plant. Spider plant flowers are very small and white with 3 to 6 petals. Spider plant is non-toxic and safe for humans, dogs and cats. This is all about spider plants. Please share with me how do you like this video in the comment section. If you like this video, then please press the like button, and to see more such videos, please consider to subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.